We are in the Rhode Show Kitchen.
Thank you.
Chef Gianfranco Campanella from Amice Bar and Grille, making Scottish salmon with wild arugula and fennel salad. Thanks for coming in.
My pleasure.
This is a perfect meal for, like, you know, the warm weather's here. It all fresh ingredients, all fresh produce, and it just makes you feel like summer.
And that's exactly what we're doing at Amici now. We're just switching the menu off and making a lot lighter dishes and things that, you know, make you feel good too.
Right, and this is something easy anybody can whip up during the week.
Super easy. Okay. A lot of people see it on TV, and now we're going to show you how to do it.
All right.
So basically what we have is fresh Scottish salmon.
Okay.
And what we're going to do is take egg whites and kosher salt, and we're going to mix it together, make a crust, and crust the top of it, bake it in the oven, which will help it retain all its moisture, and just make a really fresh salad with a citrus vinaigrette, some fennel, cucumber, carrot, bell peppers, and you won't feel guilty after you eat it.
It's good for you, too. Now, you know, you were saying it's Scottish salmon.
Yes.
Where are we going to get this? I mean, can we go to any...
Most supermarkets will have at least 3-4 types of salmon that they're going to sell, especially your higher-end supermarkets. You're going to see anywhere from sockeye salmon to Scottish salmon to the Atlantic salmon, Canadian salmon.
Right.
But you'll find it, I mean, take whatever you like, whatever salmon you enjoy,
and
just apply the same application to it.
Okay, perfect. All right, we have our ingredients ready to go. We'll come back in just a few minutes, mix everything up, and start cooking. In the meantime, back to you.
For now, we're going to be heading back to the kitchen. How's that salmon going, Michaela?
Oh, it's great. We know we have something very important that we want to talk about now. Of course, Chef Gianfranco Campanella from Amici Bar and Grill joins us, and Brian Hodge to tell us more about the Federal Hill Stroll.
That's right. Thanks very much for having me. It's Tuesday, June 5th, from 4:30 to 7:30, and it's just a lovely night out in one of the country's best Little Italies.
Yeah, that's so true. And what can people experience while they're there? What is it like? They purchase a ticket, and then... they kind of have free reign.
Exactly, right. Tickets are $30, and we like to compare it to trick-or-treating for adults. So that $30 gets you 2 drink tickets. It grants you access to a still-growing list of participating venues, including Amici and some of our favorites up on the hill. And it's really just a great atmosphere. It's no reason once you experience the event. Mm-hmm. It's no wonder why the event was named one of the best events in Rhode Island by Yankee Magazine.
Yeah, and it's a great way, too, to kind of taste food from different restaurants that maybe you haven't been to before.
Exactly. You really get a broad sampling of everything the Hill has to offer.
And so... Gianfranco, tell me what it was like last year when you guys were crowned the king of the entire stroll. What was that like?
It was awesome. I couldn't bring it in. The crown wouldn't fit.
Oh, yeah. You wouldn't be able to sit there.
No, it was a great time. Actually, it was a lot of people that showed up, and we put out a huge amount of food. And, you know, everybody was happy. Everyone's in a good mood. It's not something where people are, you know, no one's complaining. It's just a really, really good time, and we lucked out. The weather was fabulous last year. Hopefully this year will be just as great, and, you know, it was awesome.
And more delicious food to look forward to.
We put out a huge spread.
Okay.
So.
Excellent. We're going to make some delicious food here in just a bit. We want to thank both of you for coming in. Make sure you guys get your tickets to the Federal Hill Stroll, and we'll finish this dish in just a bit. Back to you.
We are back in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning. Chef Gianfranco Campanella is here from Amici Bar and Grill, making Scottish salmon with wild arugula and fennel salad. And this looks awesome.
And we have our gloves on.
And we have our gloves on. We are really professional today. Mm-hmm. We are ready to go.
All right, ready?
Ready.
Yes.
Okay. Michaela, you're going to make a salt crust. Okay, a lot of people get a little bit scared about this because they think, oh, it's going to make the food too salty.
Mm-hmm.
But the egg whites, I took the liberty of separating the yolks to the whites. So there's 3 in here.
Got it.
And in that, we're going to add about 12 ounces of kosher salt.
Okay.
A lot of salt.
A lot of salt.
Now, you're going to mix that up with your hand, so you get kind of going like a whisk kind of manner. There you go.
It almost becomes like a paste, right?
Exactly. That's what you're going to do. You're going to make it pasty.
Okay.
What I suggest at home is first try it this way, and then you can go ahead and you can add different flavors to that. You can add juniper berries to the crust. You can add lavender to the crust. You can add anything you want, so you can actually make it. And what you're looking for is kind of like a nice thick consistency.
Okay.
So
I think we got it.
You're going to make the salad.
Okay.
I'm going to sear the salmon.
Okay.
Here you have some bell peppers, red onions, fennel, some cucumber, carrots. Please, feel free, add whatever you like.
All right, I like it
all. Throw it all in there. And that's so great. I mean, even just the colors of fresh vegetables in the
summertime.
You could probably grow some of these in your own garden, too.
Absolutely. So now we got a hot pan,
mm-hmm.
some extra virgin olive oil, And we got the salmon, we left the skin on. So what will happen is the salt crust will help keep the moisture out from the top, the skin will help keep the moisture from the bottom.
Oh, excellent.
So we're going to pan sear that. Mm-hmm. Careful. I don't want to burn you.
So skin side up.
Skin side up. Okay. There's no reason to pan sear the skin. And if you do pan sear the skin, it's going to start pulling away from the meat as it cooks.
Okay.
And you'll see that we're going to get a nice hard sear on this. Mm-hmm. And what that'll help do is also help keep all the juices inside the salmon.
And salmon, it's easy to see it cooking because it's literally, it's just changing colors before your eyes. So
this is actually sushi-grade salmon, so okay. We can actually even eat it raw. And there's actually even another method
even
that when you sear it, you can actually do what's called a different color scale on it. So mm-hmm. you can get a nice hard sear, then a nice medium, then a nice mid-rare, and then rare on the bottom. So,
but it's easier to tell rather than a piece of meat, if you will. You can't see it change as much.
Absolutely. So now,
just the colors in this look like summer.
It's beautiful, yeah, isn't it? Yeah. Get rid of the tongues. You got gloves on. All right. So you got a little bit of lemon juice in here.
Yep.
There's two lemons there that I've juiced for you.
Okay.
I'm going to add to that probably about third of a cup of extra virgin olive oil.
Yep. Just whisk this together.
And just really simple, a little kosher salt. Whisk that together.
Okay.
Dress this out, and then with your hands, toss it up nicely,
okay.
And then make
place
me a nice
plate. Okay.
And if you pass this, I'll hire you.
No.
We're looking for help on the weekends right now.
We'll see if I can be your sous chef.
It's all about the presentation, though.
I'm going to grab the fish spatula.
Okay.
We're going to look for the crust.
We
got a nice golden sear on there.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to use this heavy ramekin plate.
Okay.
Apply crust to it.
All right. A lot? Do I just kind of...
Go ahead.
Okay.
Liberal.
All right. I feel like I'm snowing on this.
Thing?
Well, I mean, what would you... let's say
I love salad.
Then... As much as
all
you
right.
want.
Okay.
Okay, so now we're going to add the rest of this.
Okay.
And then what we're going to do is just form it around the salmon.
Wow.
And you would think that it's going to make it super salty.
Yeah, I'm a little nervous.
But the egg whites will bind it all together.
Okay.
And actually prevent it from actually...
There it is.
So now what this makes is kind of like an igloo around it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Without an opening to go in.
Okay.
And it'll bake and it'll steam.
Okay, so for the sake of time... We're going to cook it in here. We bake it for about how long?
It's going to go in the oven.
Okay.
And usually about 15 minutes, it's ready to go.
It's ready to go.
If you like it well done, just let it go. And the way you can tell, so we're mm-hmm. going to put it in the oven.
Okay.
And then we're going to wait 15 minutes, and then magically.
Voila!
Magically, here it is. Oh, see how it comes out. Look at that. There it is.
Oh, there we go.
So when the crust is nice and golden brown,
mm-hmm.
you kind of know it's ready. So it should.
Come right off.
Excellent.
That's how you do
good.
It.
Not all of that salt is going.
Do not
your
eat
day.
This because that will be salty.
All right. And if you want this recipe, you can head to our website, WPRI.com.